If they ain't got it, I'ma mask up and take it. 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 Mask up and take it.
What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? AJ Good here at the House of Masks, and in today's video, we are doing a Buckethead unboxing. Now, it is no secret that Buckethead is a very big Texas Chainsaw Massacre fan. And it's no secret that he takes a lot of inspiration from Texas Chainsaw Massacre and Leatherface. Everything from his mannerisms.
Numbers like a playground and alphabets across the wall. This is the hand that does it, you know?
Ed Gein! Don't run Ed Gein!
Ed!
Bubba's been playing with her. Bubba likes her. Bubba's got a girlfriend!
To props that he uses on stage. To his wardrobe. Right down to a couple masks that he actually wears from time to time.
Shame on a nigga who tried to run game on a nigga. But why would the trigger?
In today's video, we are going to be unboxing one of those masks. Yes, in today's package, we are unboxing a Leatherface mask that is actually getting somewhat hard to find. Price is going up, and that's when you can find them. And this is one of those pieces that I never thought that I would ever even want to purchase, let alone pay a decent amount of money for. But I figured I might as well go ahead and get it out of the way, because it's only downhill from here. Because today we have Ruby's Leatherface mask. Based on the main mask that was used in the 1974 original Texas Chainsaw Massacre. The killing mask, if you will. And as you can see, this is absolutely nothing special. It was shipped in an envelope, so it's pretty flat. It's definitely going to need stuff so that it looks a little better. But yeah, just another one that I needed to add to the set. Buckethead used this in the behind the scenes of the We Are One music video. So you'll see him and Surge hanging out, and he's acting all goofy and doing karate moves and all kinds of shit in this mask. He also used it from time to time on various DVDs that he's released, and he actually ripped the hair out at one point, and his dad wears it in one of those DVDs. So that's kind of cool. And most notably, the thing that I think of when I think about this mask is this really weird photo that was taken of him wearing this mask and a Happy Holidays shirt, and he's holding the hand of a little girl, which out of context seems very strange, but when you think about what's actually going on, it's not that weird. That's probably one of his nieces or something, and that's how against having his photo taken he is, that he always has a mask, and he just happened to have this one with him and threw it on for that photo. So definitely a strange thing at first sight. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and stuff this thing and make sure that it's all properly displayed. Obviously, these are out of production and have been for quite some time, and if you're a Buckethead collector or a Texas Chainsaw Massacre collector, I would recommend going ahead and picking one up if you can find one, because they are shooting up. Prices, just since I purchased mine, have gone up, and my buddy the Mask Hunter was the one that tipped me off about where they were, and between him buying the two copies he got, they actually went up as well. So I would recommend grabbing one just for the sake of having one. Not saying you have to display it. It is what it is, but you never know what these things might be worth one day. So if you can find one, I would go ahead and get it. I may end up grabbing a second copy to take the hair off of, to give it the look that it had when Buckethead's dad was wearing it, but for right now I'm just going to be leaving this one alone and probably putting it with my old Distortions Leatherface. Once again, not a piece that I ever thought would be in my collection, not a piece that I ever thought that I would want, but somehow Buckethead has made it cool, and somehow I'm stoked to add it to the collection. So yeah, gonna stop talking now, go ahead and stuff this thing, show it off. That will be today's video. I hope that you guys enjoyed it, and we will see you later.